The way that we pick songs at Harvest is we have a process behind it. It's not very romanticized. It's basically called 1 through 5. And what we do is we categorize our songs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the most important thing is the 5. And here's the example I always give. If the four of us, I got all the four of us right now on a plane, and we flew to England, because that's obviously where I'd like to take you. And
I'd go.
And thank you. And you know, it takes us 7 hours to fly over there, and we spent 7 days going around London and England. And after day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5, you guys were like standing in front of all these awesome places, all these castles, Buckingham Palace, you know, all these great shopping streets we could go to. And every time I take you to one of those places, you guys are like, well, that's really cool, Andy, but I really did like that plane that we went on. That plane was really nice. I mean, that seat was really nice. You know, wouldn't that be a bit odd?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And so in the worship community, you know, I think what we do is sometimes we elevate the vehicle, you know, and we don't elevate the destination. And I drove here this morning, you know, to film this. Every day when I finish work, I go home. You know, everything I do has a destination to it. And worship is the most important thing that we do. And therefore, the most important thing about worship must be the destination. And that's why the destination of our worship must be something that's beyond ourselves. And it must be all about God. And so the last song that we sing, our 5 in a worship set every week, is what we call a vertical song. It's usually purely ascriptive. You know, it's totally looking up. It's not about me anymore. And how we get there is we start with gathering songs. Those are our ones, right. You know, where we're calling people to worship. We know that Jim and Carol have just dropped their kids off, you know, in the kids ministry, and I know that I can't get them to a deep place of worship immediately. So I'm leading them with songs that say, you know, we've waited for this day, we're gathered in your name, calling out to you, you know, open up the heavens, we want to see you. Show us your glory, show us your glory. You know, and then we want to lead them through a time where, just like when we pray, you know, we go through, you know, that common thing. Sometimes we go through like adoration, confession, thanksgiving, supplication. There needs to be a place in our worship when we sing where we're singing about our own needs, you know, and those are our 3 songs, you know, where we sing our own testimonial songs, where we sing songs about how we're doing in our lives and the valleys that we're going through. And then we lead people through that, from gathering to testimonial to vertical songs. Now, the 2s and the 4s, you might be thinking, well, they're the songs that kind of fit in between those categories, you know. And the way that we order all those songs out is not by music, it's not by tempo, it's all by lyric. You know, so we look at the lyric. Is this lyric a gathering lyric? Is this lyric a testimonial lyric, and is this lyric a vertical lyric? And a lot of the time, as you look out into the worship community, and that's why I think vertical church music is such a precious thing for us, is that when you look out into the worship community, vertical worship songs are very, very hard songs to get a hold of.
Yeah.
It's very, very hard to get hold of songs that just speak purely about the Lord. But when you lead people to a destination in worship that's vertical, you see a reaction in them that no worship leader on this planet can manufacture. Mm-hmm. Because music's a powerful thing. And I know, after leading worship, I know you guys do, yeah, too, after leading worship for so many years, like, I know how powerful music is, and we can alter people's emotions just with music. But when you lead them to a vertical lyric, you know, and you give them an opportunity to gather and then respond in testimony, but then arrive in that place, something happens within them that we cannot manufacture by ourselves. And you see often like a physical reaction, arms start going in the air, people don't know why they're doing it. It's because they're ascribing worth to the Lord. That's an awesome place to end. And so we have that value when we plan our services. We're always ending on 5s.
Oh, we thank you, Jesus. Oh, we thank you, Lord.